go, go get it. Top floor, top dog, like I just signed a TDE. Top. Gang. Know we all gotta eat. Gang. Up late, bills due, rent due, I ain't been asleep. Woo. Looking in the mirror, all I see is everything that I wanted to be. Me. My city depended on me, that's on G-O-D. Grew up watching my mom become what daddy couldn't be. Yeah. I ball like MLB, these Bottega boots ain't cheap. My car ain't got no key, I push to start my week, I'm in this. Photo poor, so photogenic, all I know is to go, go get it. Shoot my shot, now I ain't gon' miss it. All I know is to go, go get it. All my life I've been a go get up. All I know is to go, go get it. Wake up in the morning, kiss my son, then go, go get it. Go, go get it. Go, go get it. Photo poor, so photogenic. All my life I've been a go get up. Wake up in the morning, kiss my son, then go, go get it. Go, go get it. Photo poor, so photogenic. All my life I've been a go get up. Wake up in the morning, kiss my son, then go, go get it.
Snake tendency, let's go. Don't make me jog your memory. I did upgrade you, then upgraded the world. How they forgetting me? Please make it make some sense to me. How you talking about the greatest? Still ain't greatest. Mention me. Them bands, I want the symphony. 15 in it, went instantly. Lately I've been catching plays, it's like it's meant to be. I got rich in the pandemic, meant to be. Don't do too much, I keep it simple. You cloud chasing, trying to make the people.
On a warm afternoon in the Tar Heel state of North Carolina, EA Sports brings you to Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Today, our new season begins with an NFC South matchup between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Carolina Panthers. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from Uptown Charlotte. This one taken just inside the 10. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. And some space here. 12 yards on the gain. A great start for this offense.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
Hey, ball 66.
And the slot man goes in motion left. That throw by Brady incomplete. Well, that's not the way you want to start. A first pass attempt and a first drop all in one.
Well, you've got plenty of time to make up for it, but obviously not the way you want to get things started. Got to shake that off and get going.
The slot man in motion right to throw on second and 10. Brady The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Brian Burns flying in there and dropping it for the sack. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. We'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. The sack backs him up, third and long. Tough challenge for Brady in the box. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
Hey,
they'll send the slot in motion left. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. 21 yards there. A big play on fourth down. So after the big play on fourth, here's first and 10. Brady going to throw. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Meanwhile, Brady's throw on target to Godwin here. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The first red zone opportunity of the new year here as they come up now first and 10. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Mike Evans from 17 yards out. And the Bucks are on the board here first in the season opener. Extra point up and good by Succop. And that makes the score 7-0. The Bucks ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. Fields this way up at the 17. And he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line. First and 10 for the Panthers as Corral gets them set at their 25-yard line. Fakes a handoff here. Corral. Looking left sideline. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Well, Bobby, that's the start that you want right there. And you know he spent the entire offseason throwing hundreds, I'd probably say thousands of passes, getting ready for that moment. The first throw of the new season. He's dreamed about it, thought about it, and now it's out of the way.
Now one for one, a lot more to go. And he is going to lose yardage here. Yikes, a four-yard loss really sets him back now for second down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. They'll send a receiver in motion left. Throwing on second and 14. Corral. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 27. On first down, Corral. And a quick shuffle pass here is complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 20. Now a timeout called for by the defense. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. Again, it's Corral. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on third and 2.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up fourth down.
Corral into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. And the Bucs are going to get the ball back on the turnover as they hold on fourth down. I appreciate the aggressiveness trying to go for it there on fourth down, but you're in the red zone, have 3 points in your back pocket. Instead, Charles, they throw it away.
Certainly a good call to go for it on fourth down, as you said, in the red zone. Definitely going to cost them 3 points, and we'll see how that affects the game as time goes on.
Brady's throw there, incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tougher rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. Brady's throw taken in by Evans here. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. And the slot man goes in motion left. Oh, he put it on the carpet, a fumble. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. These defenses have become so opportunistic, and no matter what you're playing, in this case, wide receiver, you got to be careful.
Certainly do, because there is a phrase in today's football that we use all the time, completing the process of the catch. Well, it's after you do that where the trouble begins, right? Meaning you've tucked it away, you're trying to get downfield, but someone's always coming up trying to rake in the ball and knock it free. That incompletion certainly slows things down a little bit and brings up a very important call for second and long. What do? Run and try and get some yardage and make it third manageable, or challenge the coverage again, hoping for a bigger gain?
And now here's a deep shot that's complete. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Here's Corral on first down. Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. So that'll be no better than an incompletion, and that'll make it second down. No gain on the play. Corral takes a shotgun snap. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. And Johnson's extra point up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded right around the 8. And he's going to be taken down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they're matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
On first down, Brady. He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. And two big plays right in succession as this one goes for 27.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Cover, cover! Hey, check it! 72!
Brady now on first down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
And they'll send the slot in motion left. The pass is caught by Cade Otten. And he'll get this to the 22. So they began the play at the 11, and it's a gain of 11. First down. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
And the slot man goes in motion left. And this is incomplete. Oh, that looked like a sure 6 points. But he could not get that to stick, and that is a golden opportunity wasted there. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. There's still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Brady. And it's caught. Touchdown. Chris Godwin. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Bucs have taken the lead. Extra point put through by Succum, and that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Takes it at the 7. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. Here's Corral on first down. And this one too low.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
And they'll send the tight end in motion here. On the play fake, Corral. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Devin White defeating the offensive line and getting to the quarterback. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left. And he'll air this one deep for Anderson. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I'm not sure it made a difference on that play, but one thing to keep in mind, here in the early part of the year during a day game, the sun does play a factor on deep balls.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. In motion comes the tight end left. Fourth down, Corral looking to throw it. And this is caught. He hits Moore. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. Now on first down. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Gonna go down. They sack it back right around 30. Brian Burns in there to get him once again. That's two sacks for him now here on opening day. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Throwing on second and long. Brady. This is caught by Evans. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. And they'll send the slot in motion left. He'll get 6 on the ground there, and it'll be second and goal coming up.
That's good hard running right there on first and goal. That gets him down to the 2 and puts a lot more pressure on that defense.
Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A big play if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Now Brady. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Tom Brady, his third touchdown pass of this first half. And the Buccaneers go up by two touchdowns. Extra point up and good by Succop. And it's now 21-7. The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. From the six.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it, they're down, they're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Now after the sack, you got Corral and the Panthers here staring at a tough play, third and long. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Yetur Gross-Matos getting in there to make the play. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Whistles. Flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early.
Here we go, sack.
Final shot before the half for Corral. He's got Anderson on the slant. But they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. A gutsy call there. You exit the locker room with a lead, tried the onside kick, it didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They're already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
Fakes a handoff. Now Corral to throw it. Buying time to his left. Catch is made by Arcega Whiteside. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that will bring up second down. Play action, Corral. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. On third down, Corral. This one into the hands of the running back, Melange. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Corral with it, first down here. And that one going to come up short, low throw.
Just what they need, a lecture from me, but subpar offense is what helped get them into this spot. And now they're continuing the trend with incompletions. That won't get them out of it if they don't change something soon.
to throw once more on second and 10. Corral. Oh, he bowls over him. Runs through another. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Third down, Corral. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he is going to have the Panthers first down, at least at first glance, as he'll spot the football just beyond the marker. They'll find a way to convert on 30 inches. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Corral looking to pass. Second down. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And the Panthers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 7. Robinson up the middle. And he's up past the 10 to about the 12. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Second down and a run by Robinson. And not much here as he'll get it to the 11, maybe the 12-yard line. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. He's got Otten. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. On first and 10, it's Robinson. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down.
Hey, Alabama, Alabama.
Throwing is Brady on third down. That's out wide here for Robinson. He's got the first down and more. Down the left sideline. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. The offense has to love that, because that was just a dump down, and then he turned something out of seemingly nothing.
And the best quarterbacks understand that dumping it down is often a good play, a better play than even what was drawn up.
They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14. On second and 9, Brady. And he wisely will throw that one away. Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down.
Hey, Alabama, Alabama.
Here's Brady to throw. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. The fourth touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady. And the Buccaneers are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point put through by Succop. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fields this way up at the 17. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball.
Now it's second and nine. On second down, here's Corral.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. The Panthers on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This time it's third and three.
Corral looking to throw.
He's going to look deep for more. And he's got it inside the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Now Corral.
And he's going to go down. This will count as a sack, a very short sack, taken down at the 2.
Corral is intercepted again. That's number 3.
He's at the 50. He's at the 30. Past the 20.
And the Buccaneers are going to take possession of the football.
Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to a backup.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up, and then some on second and 13.
Robinson with another carry.
And for a second straight play, just nowhere to go, thanks to this Carolina defense. Third down, now even tougher. Third and 13 after that loss of a yard.
Not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first.
Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19.
So Brady departs, and on is Ryan Suckup for the Buccaneer field goal.
This from 36 yards out. Suckup's kick is good.
So after 4 touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced into taking the 3.
But you did mention 4 touchdowns, right? So 4 out of 5, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air.
Takes it at the 7. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
The Panthers make over first down 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Let's go now.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go.
And whatever promise they showed in the preseason has not translated into week 1, because they have not been particularly competitive here at home, no less. These fans just kind of beside themselves right now.
Multiple defenders get to him there, and that is the 6th time he's been sacked in this ball game.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair.
So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. So following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on 2nd and 13.
Corral on 2nd down.
Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. Brings it up just shy of the 25. Showed some of that quickness there on the move.
And Corral will throw it.
It completes it once more to Anderson. And he is going to have the Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Corral to throw on 1st and 10.
He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. A good gain on 1st has him set up with 2nd and just a couple of inches now from the 29.
To the air again with Corral.
Open man is Robbie Anderson.
They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. Corral to throw, first and 10. That one complete to Anderson. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Throwing again on second down. Corral, that's complete to Arcega Whiteside. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. First down, here's Corral with it. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
Corral's throw is caught here by Anderson. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. To the air again. Here's Corral. That pass complete to Moore. That he won't quite make it. He needed six. He got about five. Fourth down. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. One final play for Corral. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is going to be intercepted. And the Bucs come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. Well, this was not just the opener of a brand new season, but this was a division game here in week one. And to come through with a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward.
Boost up my rating, you know how I play with toys. Pop out on any occasion, get standing ovations. They can't help it but rejoice.